Good morning and welcome to the second annual Black Student Union Convocation. My name is Kennedy Stort and I'm the current Vice President of the Black Student Union here at GC. Woo! All of us are joined together today not just to require our card swipe, but also to join together in recognition and unity of Black History Month. Black History Month is more than just a time for us to recognize historical figures that made it possible for students like me to become leaders in the community, but also a time to continue to recognize leaders who continue to strive and make way to build better communities for students. As many of you know, I wear a lot of different hats around campus. I have been told more than once by even my own profs that I'm busier than them. In truth, I would have a lot more time if I dropped my clubs and leadership roles. And of course, the thought crossed my mind. Actually, at the beginning of just this year, I considered taking a break. Yet, I'm still standing before you, so what changed my mind? Simply put, it was my peers, the same people who continued to question me, also inspired me. If I didn't do this work standing up here guiding others in both traditional and non-traditional spaces, then who would? I identify as a Black woman, and with that label comes many challenges on a predominantly white campus that I never anticipated. But instead of letting that determine how I see myself, I'm letting that identity shine, just as the others you will hear and see from today have done. In this space, we have united to hear stories, lessons, and experiences shared by the Black community under the theme of Bold, Black, and Beautiful, a symphony of artistry and Black excellence at BSU. This convocation was heavily inspired by an event that BSU leadership was able to attend just this December at Notre Dame, an event entitled Orange Moon, that celebrated the neo-soul origins of music within the Black community. One of our very own advisors, the BSU advisor, Asia Ellington, was able to step into that space as she does annually with powerful spoken word, as well as Andrea Taylor, who stole all of our hearts that night, ears and hearts collectively that night together. From the audience, we were served with an inspiring performance, one that had us undeniably saying, how can we bring this to Goshen College? And by this, we mean that powerful Black authenticity in a space that is entirely and undeniably Black onto this very stage. I'm very proud to say that we have done just that today. You'll be treated to the delights of the purest form of local African-American talent, local talent from South Bend, to students that walk around campus every single day. We hope that as you sit in the pews today, you not only open your ears, but also your hearts. Engage with these stories with genuine intent, allowing their powerful performances to resonate with you. Also recognize that stepping onto the stage was a deliberate and meaningful choice for each performer, and appreciate the unique narratives they are bravely sharing with us about their experience living in a Black identity. And without further ado, let's give a round of applause as we welcome Peace Mugahachi to the stage.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm really honored to be here today to celebrate the bold, the Black, and the beautiful at GC. And I will be reading a poem called New Day's Lyric by Amanda Gorman. May this day we come together. Mourning, we come to mend. Withered, we come to weather. Torn, we come to tend. Battered, we come to better. Tethered by this year of yearning, we are learning that though we weren't ready for this, we have been readied by it. We steadily vow that no matter how we are weighed down, we must always pave a way forward. This hope is our door, our portal. Even if we never get back to normal, someday we can venture forward beyond it. To leave the known and take the first steps. So let us not return to what is normal, but reach forward to what is next. What was cursed, we will cure. What was plagued, we will prove pure. Where we tend to argue, we will try to agree. Those fortunes we forswore, now the future we foresee. Where we weren't aware, we are now awake. Those moments we missed are now these moments that we make. The moments we meet and our hearts, once all beaten, now all together beat. Come, look up with kindness yet, for even solace can be sourced from sorrow. We remember not just for the sake of yesterday, but to take on tomorrow. We heed this old spirit in a new day's lyric. In our hearts, we hear it. For auld lang syne, my dear, for auld lang syne. Be bold, sang time this year. Be bold, sang time. For when you honor yesterday, tomorrow ye will find. Know what we've fought need not be forgot nor for none. It defines us, binds us as one. Come over, join this day just begun. For wherever we come together, we will forever overcome. Thank you.
Thank you, Peace, for those powerful words. I'm Mariella, I'm a senior English major, and I'm a part of BSU leadership. Next, we're gonna hear from Caitlin Johnson, who will be sharing her powerful story of leaving Texas to attend a small PWI in Indiana.
Hello and good morning. I'm a little nervous, y'all. My name is Caitlin Johnson, and as many people call me, KK. I am a current freshman from Dallas, Texas, and I am on a track and field team. It is no surprise that moving halfway across the country became a struggle for me, especially being a PWI and HSI, which is a predominantly white institution and Hispanic serving institution. While being a black woman, that struggle became 10 times harder. I had not yet realized what I signed myself up for. From the moment I stepped foot on campus, I felt as though I was an outcast. During orientation week, I could feel the eyes staring at me. While I tend to be a natural extrovert, I find that I make friends quickly. It was a struggle for me to find a group of people I could relate to. My identity was now for the first time changing in a way I couldn't understand. A lot of people had already formed their groups, and friendships began to solidify in the first few days. I attempted to keep trying to put myself out there, and by doing so, friendships naturally formed. However, I wasn't ready for the social implications that this would have to those around me. I identify as a black woman, and in the small population of Goshen College, I am the minority. Almost naturally, I found that I clicked with other black students on campus. For me, I found peace within the basketball boys on campus because of our shared experiences. More than half the team are black or black identified. We talk the same, look the same, act and relate on different levels that I don't with my white peers. Our friendship in my eyes was nothing but playful and lighthearted, but then I began to almost hear the comments immediately. When I would hear these comments, I was confused as to why they were being said. I began to question the friendships that I had with these people. As the year went along, I found myself becoming lonely and miserable. Until I started to meet with Jesse Lowen about academics, then we would talk about how it felt to come to a PWI and feel secluded. He offered me advice and was supportive of how it felt to live within the minority. I want to thank Jesse for opening up his arms to me and being there for me when I need to talk or just cry. Sorry. I want Goshen College to become a space for students of color, especially for black students. We need more professors, staff, and faculty that look like us. We need people we can go to talk, cry, and even open up their arms to us to let us know that this is a place for us. Maybe if that would have happened for me, my experience would have been a little bit different. In the end, I want to leave you with this quote. Defining myself as opposed to being defined by others is one of the most difficult challenges I face. A quote by Carl Moseley. To me, this means I choose my own path and others do not get to decide for me who I become. Thank you.
Caitlin, thank you so much for your vulnerability and for being able to share those words with us. Let's give her another round of applause, please. right, hello and good morning. My name is Isis Danubia Espinosa, and I'm currently a fourth year studying secondary education and TESOL. I'm also part of BSU leadership. This morning, I have the grand privilege of welcoming Bongiwe to the stage. She's in her senior year, studying biochemistry, and she's also currently part of the Queen Singers. So please help me in welcoming Bongiwe to the stage.
Thank you for the warm welcome, and thank you for coming to celebrate the bold, black, and beautiful with the Black Student Union this morning. The song I'm about to share with you is one that my younger sister and I composed when we were in high school for corporate worship on Africa Day. It is written in our mother tongue, which is Isindebele. Unfortunately, my sister could not be here to complement the strumming with some groovy picking, but she sends her greetings from Heston College. You might notice that the lyrics make mention of Boso and Dynamos. These two teams are very famous soccer teams in Zimbabwe. However, they are often at odds. The point of making the mention of these teams was to call people on either side of the soccer feud to set aside their differences and take some time to worship together. I invite you to join me when I sing the chorus for the third time. second song I'm going to share is a recitation of Psalm 40. It is also sung in isiNdebele, and it is a recitation of just the first four verses. This song is special to me because it has been sung in my family for a couple of generations. Again, I invite you to join me when I sing Amen to right at the end. Thank you.
Hello, good morning, everyone. My name is Shakira, and I am the BSU president. Today, we are going to be reading. Today, we are going to be reading an excerpt from the book Love Letters to My Girls, a series of letters to Black women that speak to the hearts of Black women and girls everywhere. One of the letters was written by Asia Ellington, our BSU advisor, who unfortunately could not make it today. However, we wanted to leave you with just a few of her words from this book, especially Black woman, we see you. Dear black girl, my name is Jakaira.
My name is Kennedy.
And I am a Black girl.
And I am also a Black girl.
It is an honor that you have chosen my letter to read. I just want to take a few lines to dive into your life's journey, the past, the present, and the beautiful future. We all need someone to lean on. We all need support and guidance, especially from our sisters. I'm here for you always, whether in the form of a letter, phone call, or in person. You just say the word. I want you to internalize this letter and become the best version of yourself. Be strong.
Black girl, you continue to smile through your pain and respond, "I'm okay," when asked how you are doing. It is okay to be strong. In fact, I admire you for that. While being strong is important, you are also honest with yourself. And not tell the world that you are fine so often that you believe it yourself. It is okay to not be strong, and that is not okay.
You have encountered countless heartaches over the years. The traumas you experience would have easily broken most people. But you are not most people, are you? The hardships that were designed to break you, you carry them over your shoulder like a bag of laundry and continue to soar like the eagle you are. I don't believe you chose to be the family member to always have things together, the perfect black girl. Yet it often feels like you are the key to holding your family together.
Sometimes you want to stop all movement in the world and just leave, right? Fly away like the caged bird that you are. Yes, caged. That is what I see when I look at you. Caged is not a negative description. You continuously knock down the bar, blocking you to step over those barriers and break free. Young, beautiful black woman, you are unstoppable physically, mentally, spiritually, and emotionally free from the cage. When you accept it, get the map, formulate your escape plan, and direct your future, because only you know where your journey leads.
It is time for you to deal with your internal hurt or fear, or it will deal with you. I know what it's like to keep yourself busy 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, to avoid dealing with your past traumas. I also know that avoidance tactics will only work for so long before your anxiety and depression disrupt your daily activities. Before you know it, you'll be paralyzed with fear, paranoid of losing someone else, and find yourself emotionally and physically caged. This is where that heartache will lead you if you do not deal with it.
It is okay to not be okay. You were born with the heart to help any and everyone who comes across your path, but who is helping you? Even with several support systems, the bulk of the load is still on you because no one knows you like you. You know what you need. No doctor, society, social worker, or anyone else. What do you need, black girl? I want you to be the best you possible. I want you to surpass the stars and live the dreams you desire. Let me rephrase that last statement. You will surpass the stars and you will live the dreams that you desire.
I admire you.
I love you.
And I believe in you.
Be strong.
Black queen. Thank you, guys. So I'm so excited to introduce our final performance of the day, Andrea Taylor. As Kennedy mentioned, BSU had the opportunity to attend Orange Moon, a neo-soul event. We were in awe of Andrea's performance. And before she joins us on the stage, I want to give a quick background on who she is. Andrea lives in South Bend and graduated from Bethel University in 2017. She's dedicated herself to the field of education, teaching in public schools, and contributing to nonprofit organizations. While she's passionate for youth development, music has always been a part of her life. At a young age, she recalls being surrounded by and influenced by all types of music, from singing in church, car rides with her family, to overly enjoying music class in school. Her musical journey also has many accolades, including making the Gospel Billboard charts for several records and gracing the stage at the Gospel Music Award Stellars in 2017. She's also been a background vocalist for many different artists. No matter what, Andrea has remained committed to singing at Mount Carmel Missionary Baptist Church for the past decade. Currently, she serves as a proud member of the Ministry of Music under the guidance of her father and pastor. So now that you know a bit about Andrea, please let us welcome her to the stage with a round of applause.
Good morning, everyone. Wonderful. Can you do me a favor before I start to sing my song? Can we just give a round of applause for the BSU team? I know I'm not supposed to speak, but I just want to say this. I went to Bethel University, which when I was there, it was called Bethel College. And my experience there was similar to a lot of the people that came on this stage today. That feeling of not belonging, that feeling of it's just me, that feeling of being an outcast. And oftentimes when you're not a part of that, you don't really fully understand the experience. But what I encourage you today is, and I want to say to you that there's hope. There's freedom in being who you are. Don't water down who you are because somebody else that doesn't look like you doesn't accept you. So be loud, laugh loud, because I'm loud sometimes. And it's okay to be quiet and to be soft in some settings too, because God honors that. And as long as you truly, authentically be who you are, He'll get the glory. And when He shines through, there's nothing you can't do. And that's to everybody else too that doesn't look like me. Be who you are, and God will honor that, and He rewards that, okay? So I'm going to sing a song today. Y'all bear with me. It's a little new to me, but I felt super led to sing it to you all today. Scripture tells us that there's three things that will last forever. Does anyone know what that is? That's okay. They're really simple. You'll know today. Like I tell my students, don't be afraid to talk back at me, okay? So there's three things that will last forever. Scripture tells us that it's faith, hope, and can you guess what the third one is? Love. Good job. It says, and then the scripture tells us that the greatest of these is love. I just believe that if we have faith and we have hope, love automatically shines through. So today we're going to focus on faith a little bit. And then towards the end, I want to leave you with a blessing and encourage you as you leave and you embark on your day as you head to classes or you go back to your dorm to take a nap, because that's what I would do, that you're left feeling encouraged and knowing that God is near, no matter what you look like, no matter what color you are, no matter what shape you are, no matter how much money's in your pocket. No matter you don't know what the future looks like, God is near, okay? All right. Can you do me a favor? In the black church, we like to clap, so can y'all clap with me? Keep clapping. Back when I had a little, I thought that I needed a lot. A little was overrated, but a lot was a little too complicated. See, zero didn't satisfy me. A million didn't make me happy. And that's when I learned the lesson that it's all about your perception. Hey, are you a common or a superstar? So you act, feel, so you are. It's not about the size of your car. It's about the size of the faith in your heart. There's hope. It doesn't cause a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God for that. Oh, there's hope. It doesn't cause a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God for that. Oh, yeah. Off in the back country of Brazil, I met a young brother that made me feel that I could accomplish anything. You see, just like me, he wanted to sing. He had no windows and no doors. He lived a simple life and was extremely poor. On top of that, he had no eyesight, but that didn't keep him from seeing the light. He said, what's it like in the USA? And all I did was complain. He said, living here is paradise. He taught me paradise is in your mind. You know that there's hope. It doesn't cause a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God for that. Oh, there's hope. It doesn't cause a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God for that. Oh, every time I turn on the TV, somebody's acting crazy. If you let it, it will drive you crazy. But I'm taking back my power today. Prices, they keep on rising. government, they keep on lying, but we've got to keep on surviving. Oh, yeah, there's hope. It doesn't cost a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God for that. Oh, there's hope. It doesn't cost a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God for that, yeah. So stand up for your rights. Keep shining your light and show the world your smile. Can you say that with me? Stand up for.
Stand up for your rights.
Keep shining your light. Show the world your smile. A thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God for that. He's so grateful that you don't. Doesn't cause a thing to smile. You don't have to pay to laugh. You better thank God for that. There's hope. I'm so grateful. There's hope for you and me. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. All right, take your seat. Thanks for making me feel a little bit more comfortable. Believe it or not, I sing on many stages, but I still get nervous. All right, so this next song I'm going to sing with no music. And do me a favor, I want you to feel led to do whatever the Lord tells you to do. So if that is you having your eyes closed, you opening your hands to receive the blessing. Maybe you stand, whatever that looks like for you. But I want you to do me another favor, and I want you to block out every distraction. So I'm 28, so I still like my phone a lot. But try to put your phone away. Try not to think about what's next and just be in this moment, okay? May your struggles keep you near the cross, and may your troubles show that you need God, and may your battles in the way they should. May your bad days prove that God is good. May your whole life prove that God is good. May your struggles keep you near the cross, and may your troubles show that you need God, and may your and may your bad days prove that God is good. May your whole life prove that God is good.
so much, Andrea. That was so powerful. Every time I'm in awe of Black women, I swear. Okay. So your presence here all the way from South Bend has added immense value to this event, and BSU is beyond grateful. We also extend our appreciation to other individuals who contributed to shaping this occasion, such as our other performers, Peace, Bongaway, Kennedy, Caitlin, and Mrs. Summers. We wouldn't have been able to host this convo without their willingness to share their stories and talent. So with that said, I have always and will continue to encourage everyone to uplift Black individuals every day, not just during Black History Month, once a year. So, if you're interested in supporting Black Cubs, remember that BSU is open to everyone, especially our Black students and staff. We would love to have you there. So to get involved, our Instagram is up there, BSU_GC, or you can reach out to us on email at bsu@goshen.edu. So remember, this is just one out of many ways you can support Black students and staff, the Black community on this campus and everywhere. So once again, a big thank you to all who have joined us today. Happy Black History Month. And also, let's take a minute to remember and advocate for the Black countries like Congo and Sudan who are being displaced in silence at this very moment. So, will you use your voice for them or continue ignoring the millions of Black men, children, and women who are facing a silent genocide? So be on the lookout for upcoming events for BSU standing in solidarity with the Congolese people. And before you leave and get up, Ms. Summers is going to play a rendition of Lift Every Voice and Sing, which I feel like is very applicable. So again, make sure you're truly listening before getting up to leave. And after she's done, we can leave. So thank you again.